Finally, twin beds making their way back into the RV market. 3,940 pounds. This is the Winnebago 2108 TB here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. My name is Josh the RV Nerd, and it was my original idea that actually inspired this concept right here. I listened to a lot of feedback from a lot of folks like yourselves watching these videos, and I kept hearing people over and over again asking, where's the twin beds? Where's the twin beds? Well, you know, you could find them very, very uncommonly in the RV industry. And I threw this idea at Winnebago. I said, take your very popular 2108 FBS with the front bed and just throw a pair of twin beds in there, have full storage under it, extra storage above, and then add a little sort of twin to king conversion method. So this thing could be two individual single beds for couples camping, maybe for like a single parent raising a kid or taking a kid out camping, for buddy camping, for hunting, or name another small, under 4,000 pound tandem axle trailer with a king bed in the front of it and full access with the slide closed. Go ahead, I'll wait. It's a short list. We're gonna talk about a ton of cool things on this RV. Well, one of them is it's full, basically, level of travel accessibility. There's two tiny cabinet doors around the entertainment center that you won't be able to get to, and you're really not gonna be able to see the TV. But I don't think a lot of people are super worried about that in transit. I think what people want to know is, can I get to the kitchen? Can I get to the bathroom? And the answer there is yes and yes. You can clearly see how even with the slide closed, we can cruise right through here. The other thing is, when I started this video, I was actually just laying on that bed up there. So this one always has bed access. So whether, you know, if you make a quick travel stop or if you're just trying to get into the camper and pack up, this one can do it all. Now, there are several RVs actually in active production in the industry today that I actually inspired, that I submitted ideas to the manufacturers and they listened to me. When you're a large dealer that does good business like we do, it gives us a pretty decent voice with the manufacturers. And, you know, every now and then, they really do listen. And this is something that is just very different, very cool, and I think very quickly, you're going to watch other RV manufacturers. They're going to be watching this. And in about a year, year and a half from now, you're going to watch a lot of other twin beds sneak into the marketplace. Now, Rockwood RV, they've had a couple here and there. They just introduced one into the GeoPro series, the 15TB that we offer here at Haylett RV, and their A-frame, the A213. A lot of the success of those models has been based on the idea of the twin to king convertible bed concept that we're looking at here. And it's not going to take long. Manufacturers are going to jump on this. I think you're going to see a version of this come out with a sofa. I think you're going to see versions of this come out in the 8-foot wide segment with longer mattresses. I think you're going to see something like this maybe even sneak into the Micro Mini 5th wheel segment that Winnebago is releasing. So I think that you'll see multiple aspects and takes on this through time. And what's cool about this, it's the many and multi-varied uses of this concept. So what if you're just a single person? Well, you know, you could very easily remove one of those mattresses and in a sense, create your own little, I don't know, desk arrangement in a way. You could have, I talked to a fella, he's like, look, I'm a single dad, I've got one son, I just want to take him camping. I don't want to have to get a whole bunkhouse just for the two of us. This gives us the ability of two separate beds and we can both feel comfortable. Now, then there's people like me and my wife. We go to bed at significantly different times. I'm usually in bed 3 to 4 hours after her. I'm just a night owl. That's just how my body is wired. She is not. But she also gets up earlier and gets our kid ready for school, you know, so she's got different things that kind of dictate her sleep schedule. Well, a camper like this, even though when we're camping, sleep schedules for school aren't as much of a concern, the fact is that's how our bodies are wired at this point. So we could go to bed at different times, we could not disrupt each other, one of us could toss and turn at night, the other could still sleep well. It just gives you so many different abilities. Or, you know, how about the fact that with just a simple little conversion plank and some bonus mattresses, this thing converts right down into from a pair of twin beds into a king. And then just like that, we convert from those twin beds into this 6-foot, 9-inch wide wall-to-wall king with those cross-breeze windows, thanks to a handy little conversion plank and sort of extra filler cushion that creates the base of the mattress at the bottom there, over that gap in the center, the expanse. Now, You can store those sort of like in that compartment right there very quickly and easily if you are looking to convert from twin beds during the day to king bed at night. Or you can just leave it a king bed and enjoy a bigger bed than any smaller RV normally is ever capable of offering, because king beds and small campers are exceptionally uncommon. King beds and travel trailers are rare, but in mini campers like this, they're virtually unheard of. Or just leave it twin beds and leave the conversion plank and stuff at home. Now, we've got full overhead storage above this thing, which is pretty darn cool. But notice that the front wall here, you have that extra utility shelf with household and USB plugs on both sides of the bed. Now, that would be very handy for alarm clocks, phone chargers. You could plug in like the cord for a heated blanket or something like that up there. You could also use those for, like, put CPAP machines up there, and then the hose just dangles down toward your face so it's not constantly pulling against you at night. I mean, the possibilities of this floor plan are many and varied. And because I know a lot of people are going to be really kind of curious as to how this works, I thought I'd kind of show it in the in-between half setup stage. This also gives you a good idea of the thickness of the mattresses. So there's this simple, lightweight, but very strong sort of middle conversion plank right here. And very rarely are you ever going to actually be putting a lot of weight on that, but it's so thin because it's not so wide. There's not a big expanse where it has to support that weight. It's going to be fine. Secondly, you have a pair of these little bonus conversion mattresses right here. And these things, they're like, what is this, like 7-8 inches thick. They're huge. The other thing is, you're not sleeping on bunk mattresses. And that's one of the reasons I wanted to pull away the veil, so to speak, or in this case, the bedspreads, and split them up so that you get to see that you're actually sleeping on individual, real mattresses. You're not sleeping on little, like, bunk mattresses that you might find in a common camper. They really thought this one out, guys. They really planned and executed this one exceptionally well. I'm very happy with what I see here. Now, another thing that we have going on here is this full privacy curtain. Like many of the other Winnebago 210 whatever series, 2106, 2108, DS, FBS, now the TB, whatever, you know, what have you. What's kind of cool, though, is again, that space between those twin beds, it makes for a really neat, handy, quick change dressing room. Or if you do have a guest sleeping on the dinette over here, maybe grandpa and grandma, and you've got a grandkid or something like that over here, it does give you that visual breakpoint to have a semblance of privacy, you know? The ability to just maintain some personal decency while you have another person in the camper. Now, something I could have or should have spoken about earlier is that at the time of this filming, Winnebago has just changed the wood tones in their interior decors. This is what they've gone to here. I don't know the name of the color they have. I'm not really that worried about it because this is how they come now. Winnebago's for a lot of years had a near stark white, like bone colored wood tone interior decor, and it really separated them, but it kind of felt like it ran its course, and they wanted to keep that lighter feel because lighter feels brighter, brighter feels bigger, and bigger feels better, I think, to people. So they went with something a little more neutral and I think a little more warm, not so cold like a doctor's office, with the, I'm just going to call it honey wood tone. I don't know what you'd really call it. I'm not good with colors, you know. My crayon box, I could get by on one of the boxes of crayons that only have 8 crayons. I don't need the 64 pack. I need red, blue, green, yellow, etc. I think you know what I mean. Anyway, another thing here, though, let's get off of that note. And storage. They gave you access to pretty much anything and everything, whether it's inside or outside. Although the full pass-through, that does remain accessible only from the outside. So you do have, in a sense, a segregated interior-exterior. You've also got a handy little space in between here to be able to set alarm clocks or personal items like glasses or books or something like that, you know? And we already saw how there's full storage down here. Now, other than the bed, I've spent a lot of time talking about the bed because really it's the key unique focal point of this camper. From here back, it is identical to a 2108 FBS, which is the fixed bed, the walk-around queen bed model. There's no differences from here backwards. But let's start with the kitchen. We've got the same sort of, pocket screwed cabinetry, hardwood cabinet door frames. The construction of the camper hasn't changed at all, only just the color of that skin. Now, this is a little camper, but it still has centralized air conditioning. And another neat thing is that Winnebago's air vents can be turned and closed individually. So if you're like me, I like to have cold air blowing directly on me all the time. I'm a hot box of an individual. I create tons of body heat. My wife, however, I think she's like part ice princess because she's always frozen. I should let it go. See what I did there? That's a Disney joke. Moving on. It's cold. I'm trying to keep myself going here, guys. Pardon me. But we've got, my point is that you can control your AC. Now, we've got a full 6 cubic foot, 2-door fridge freezer in this little camper. You notice we have a full microwave, a full stovetop. Also, take note of the fact that we have both back and side splashes. Winnebago is really killing the details and the execution of this. Now, the stovetop cover has been there for a while, but they changed the sink covers up a little bit. You see the black plasticky resin sink cover on the left. That's been there for a while. We still have stainless sinks below. They haven't cheapened up the construction. Actually, there's things like the countertops. They've recently added money to the construction of these. But they changed one of these to a roll-away aluminum drying rack, which is very handy so that, you know, it's one less thing that you need to worry about storing in the camper. And then when every ounce of prep space counts, you do have the little kitchen countertop extension here. Full plywood box ball bearing glides, and you do have space for a small waste basket in here. Now, one thing that I haven't talked about are windows, and that is something Winnebago's very good at. You notice how they gave you 3 campsite windows here. Now, they couldn't do a single massive window like they normally do due to the presence of these overhead cabinets, and I think you want that storage. And real quick note, you might be looking at this going, yeah, I get it. There's lots of cabinets, but where's my hanging closet? That's in the bathroom. Don't worry. We're getting there. You know, there's a lot of different things to cover here. But these windows tilt open in a jowl-y fashion for rainy day airflow. And note that even your main entry door has a full window. Winter Wonderland, as I said. We got a full window here, and it does have its own interior privacy shade as well. Now, as we turn around, what's kind of cool about this model is that you can utilize these twin beds in a number of different ways, but it's also very cool. Like if I just come over here during the day, I'm gonna keep my foot off your mattress, by the way, but if I just kind of kick my foot up, you could have your head resting on a couple pillows, and this could be a really neat sort of daytime lounge. You know, or you could, in a way, you could get like a free-floating card table, and you could almost have this thing set up like a dual dinette. You could have a small table like off the edge of your twin beds or anything like that. And it gives you a really easy way to take in a lot of entertainment and have a lot of personal lounge space on a rainy day, you know. Not a lot of campers are going to offer you anything like that. Now, I mentioned how they've upgraded the countertops, and I want to zoom in close on this up here. This is a full sealed edge pressed membrane counter. So you can spill a drink on here. I don't recommend it, but I mean, you can spill a drink on it and it's not going to hurt it. And then of course we've got this huge window over here for just some excellent, excellent airflow. But we've also got full shades for nighttime privacy. But where you really appreciate that is right now. You pull that shade for privacy and note how, I mean, how quickly you blotted out the sun. So you're keeping that heat from the sun out during the summertime. And we'll talk more about heating and cooling in just a minute. But you've also got a fold-down sleeper dinette right here. Now, it'd be good for one grandkid, maybe 2 little ones, or, you know, maybe you throw a big dog up there. One of the reasons I like to mention dogs is this is one of the most pet-friendly things you can look at because it is completely carpetless with no heating vents in the flooring or whatsoever. No carpet in the slide, no carpet around the dinette. They built their stuff a little bit different in that regard, and it's a very easy thing for people to miss. In my experience, when people are shopping, they look up, but when they camp, they look down. That's why I like to kind of spin the camera here, there, and everywhere. Now, I said we talk about heating and cooling. First of all, despite the small size of this, because it costs so little, we will typically upgrade this to a 15,000 BTU air conditioner. So even in the hottest of climates, you're going to be comfortable. And then to improve upon that even further, we will very often equip this also with what Winnebago calls their weather package. What it is there's a heat reflective layering that starts at the rear wall of the RV. It wraps all the way through the ceiling, across the entirety of the roof, through the nose of the RV to help keep the sun out, basically, to help keep this thing a little more comfortable. Then they do a double layer of that reflective material in the belly to help with heating efficiency. So, you know, if you're running your air conditioner, cold air wants to bleed out of the bottom of the camper. Well, having that barrier there helps keep things where they belong for longer. Additionally, we've got full storage going on here below the dinette. Now, this is good for infrequent use stuff, like maybe guest blankets or something like that, or like a big, I don't know, crock pot that occasionally you just pull out, not all the time. One quick note on that stereo, something I hadn't mentioned previously, is that it is Bluetooth and app ready. So if you want to sync your phone to it, that's great. You can just play music through it. There's also the J Control app by Jensen that you can get, and you can control your phone from this thing, which is pretty darn cool. The other thing here is they're really good about using a little bit higher grade electronics, kind of like everything else. Everything in this is really a material premium RV. Like I can walk over here and you can hear real wood, not like fiberboard. I mentioned the hardwood cabinet door frames, the pocket screwing. I mentioned the stainless steel sink, the better countertops. Everything in this is a very material premium trailer. Now back here in this bathroom, which has proven very successful through the Micro Mini line, we've got plenty of leg room, handy foot flush here, and we've also got a decent sized shower for a small camper. This is a big shower that actually offers decent elbow room for even a bigger guy like me. And that's part of the reason they have this radius shower track up here to give you more elbow room. Now, remember how I said when we got to the bathroom, we would get to see the closet. It's part of the reason they make three different variants of these Micro Mini floor plans. You've got the FBS fixed bed, the DS double sofa, if you will, which is a Murphy bed. And then you've got the TB here, which is the twin to king bed. They each have little variances, little advantages, little disadvantages as compared to one another. And that's why we keep them all in stock here at Haylett RV, so you can really pick the one that works for you. But back here, that is right here, this closet where I paused for a minute. This is where you're going to have the biggest bulk of your hanging storage. And then we still have a nice bathroom mirror right here so that you can stand directly in front of a very nice adult-sized stainless sink, one you can actually get your hands into. And just by the funny nature of the shape of this floor plan, maybe accidentally, maybe purposely, I don't know, they created a chunk of counter space back here, actually a place to be able to like put a toothbrush holder and, or, you know, hand soaps and hand wash or, you know, sanitizer or something like that. Couple key things to hit on right away as we step outside, first of which we are today looking at the platinum exterior skin color. Now, Winnebago offers multiple different exterior skins, mostly because they use a different fiberglass. They're able to do that, whereas a common Phylon style or even high gloss fiberglass, you can't buy them in multiple different colors. Manufacturers don't offer that. But the company that makes Winnebago skin, well, you can pretty much order whatever color you want from them. It just depends on what sort of coloring they put in the dye that day. Here's the thing though, this is a much higher grade fiberglass. It actually doesn't come in a roll. It's too thick to roll, it would crack. It is a much thicker, much heavier, much stronger fiberglass. And what's nice about that is it also has superior serviceability. One, it has more UV resistance and it helps reflect a lot of sun. Now, if you live in the Arizona sun country, yeah, you might need to use a little bit of that Meguiar's anti-oxidation stuff on it here and there, but the fact is, you can bring this back from a hard fade to shining just like it is today, brand new, straight from the factory. The other thing here is what was optional is now standard, and that is the 15-inch off-road package and suspension lift. That has been available on the Micro Minis for a while, and you've never really seen us talk about it much here at Haylett RV, because here in the Midwest, people tend to park camp, and we don't have as much call for that. But I know that a lot of people in a lot of other areas of the country, they go off-road, you know, they desert camp, they boondock, whatever you want to call it. So Winnebago said, you know what? We're just going to make this standard here. But what I like is, you've got bigger tires, taller suspension. You still, it's funny, it says all terrain. Apparently today it's all weather, because obviously we're in a little bit of a winter wonderland today. But you still have that nice galvanized steel wheel well down here. So God forbid you're off the beaten path and something catches one of those big radials right there, it's not going to blow the crap out of the bottom of your RV, because last thing you want is that tire giving up the ghost and wrecking part of your kitchen, or the other tire on the other side of the RV having a problem and wrecking your slide out. You know, that I've seen that happen. But notice too, they've got the steps positioned so that it's still an easy 1-2 step up with that anti-slam entry door and a bigger entry handle. Now, Quick note over here, of course, I forgot to leave the door open, partially because it's a little snowy and I didn't want to leave it open longer than I had to. But you've got the same, like, huge baggage door on this that you might have on a 2108 DS, but with the full pass-through storage a little bit closer to a 2108 FBS. It's kind of in between in a way. Slam latches, magnet catches, and double of both of those at that make the door stay in place and very easy to operate. Now, because the storage goes all the way under the bed, this has the ability to have more pass-through storage and more just belly storage in a sense than any other Winnebago Micro Mini. It's huge up here, guys. Look at how massively deep and expansive that is. Now, the full side, I don't know, call it storage trough that we're looking at right here, there's a matching one on the other side. And note, remember, there are interior to exterior compartment doors to be able to get to that storage from inside or outside. So if you plan on how you pack this thing, you can really get a lot of different use out of it. Right below that, you see those white tags hanging down? That's an outside gas grill quick connect, and it's not located under the awning. So if you do want to grill up a storm while you're outside, you can make sure that you're, first of all, keeping the heat out of the camper instead of cooking inside. And secondly, even though it's not a practical concern, a lot of people worry about cooking under the awning and like staining it. It's just not a real practical concern. It doesn't tend to happen. There's enough airflow, it doesn't tend to occur. Winnebagos all ride on a little bit different chassis. It's a Z-frame, not an I-beam, and it's made with a higher grade steel. It's not less expensive. It's lighter weight, but more expensive. That's kind of the offset. But it also tends to lend itself to RVs with better service records. And here at our dealership, we carry a lot of different brands, and we're very happy with the service output of a lot of them. Like Passports and Apexes, they have amazing service records, but yet nothing has quite topped Winnebago. There's a couple that came close, a couple times there, but Winnebago continues to be per capita the highest quality unit, and by that I mean it stays out of our shop and it stays in your driveway. And I think that says a lot, and I think it has a lot to do with the chassis, because if you want a good house, you start with a good foundation, guys. Now, this is an easy towing little camper right here, which is another reason that I really like this thing. This is a 7-foot wide body, so it's not as imposing behind your vehicle. It doesn't tend to bully smaller vehicles, you know, with like, say you got something with a, I don't know, a 5,000-7,000 pound tow rating. This thing is going to handle a lot easier behind it because, one, you get less wind resistance with the narrow body. Two, it's easier to see around, which is just a nice benefit. Always get towing mirrors though, guys. Don't ever not do that. And secondly, thirdly, you've got tandem axles. So it helps eliminate a lot of that wiggle, and it really makes the tongue weights on this a lot more manageable. We do have a simple side mount solar prep plug right about here. We also, as I mentioned, on the other side, but here's an easy way to get to see the double magnet latches. And we also have fully sealed piano hinges. And weather like this is when it's really nice, because it's snowing a little bit. It's slightly below freezing right now. Earlier, it was just above freezing. Well, if you get water freeze, water freeze, water freeze, well, water expands when it freezes. And if this was an exposed hinge, water got in it and then froze and expanded, it could spring a hinge. Well, now it's protected. Now that's not an issue whatsoever. And just another look at that beautiful T60 diesel pusher gel coat skin that they have going on here. Little bit of shipping grime on it because this RV literally just got off the delivery driver's truck. The good news is you don't pay to get a camper cleaned at Haylett RV. You don't pay extra to get propane and battery. You don't pay extra for us to show you how it works. We don't do hidden fees at Haylett RV, and we show you how everything works. Just that's just part of the tag. Basically, guys, if you see a price tag on our site, if you click the web special price on our website, taxes and tags, that's the only other additional things you have to consider, and nobody can get around those, unfortunately, because those are state things. Nice centrally located docking station, black flush, separate cable and satellite hookups, as well as a full outside utility shower back here. And they still have a full bumper. Now, the bumper caps are included. A lot of times when they come in from the factories, they are shipped loose inside the camper when we just pop them into place when they get here. Obviously, a spare tire is part of the standard package, and that's excellent. I hope you never need it, just like cough medicine. But boy, I sure hope you got it when you do need it. Normally, I'd be happy to climb up on top of a roof of an RV and show you around, but with the weather, I just don't think that's a real bright idea. Now, I've been accused of being a lot of things. Smart's never really been one of them, but I am smart enough to stay off an icy roof if I can help it. That being said, it is a fully walkable roof, and this is an all-aluminum structure. You have full aluminum caging in the floor, in the laminated walls, even the roof trusses. The ladder obviously gives you easy access up there. Now, the only hiccup with that huge baggage door and the location of that bedside window is that it does kind of shrink the potential for our awning space a little bit, but I think that's a small price to pay for all the really cool and unique features like that twin to king bed that we get inside. And frankly, I like the easy access to all the storage in that pass-through, and I like that big bedroom window. And if the one thing that I really, really want is more shady space on my campsite, in that huge front compartment, I could very easily go to the big box store of my choice and get one of those 10x10 easy ups. And I could, without a sweat, overcome the potential shorter awning here that you're running into and come up with my own solution. That stuff is not difficult whatsoever. And if that's what you need to take this camper home, you give us a call. Chances are we can make stuff happen, guys, because we are creative people and we make things happen. That's how we've become the largest independent RV dealer in the state of Michigan. And being dedicated and coming out here in the snow with my hands freezing because I can't wear thick gloves when I'm running a camera, you know, it's that kind of dedication that persists through our store. It's just a good reflection of the culture that we have here at Haylett RV. So we don't do hidden dealer fees, but we do hitching, pieces, parts, trades, finance, truck and trailer package deals, RV delivery, and everything else in between. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.